We got codes that we live by, codes that you don't break. Big bro always told me, keep my friends close, but my enemies closer. Bay laws, stick to the code, 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 code.
That bitch Sharia out of pocket and sweat crossing the nigga that she been on. Them niggas could be anybody. What the fuck is wrong with that bitch?
Do we have a deal? Why that 200K is with you? Will change our lives. They got 20K.
Damn.
Okay,
what's up, bitch? Wait, what?
Hold up. Let me get this thing off my alarm. Okay, what the fuck you
say happened with my nigga? Oh, nephew? What the fuck did you do? Trill. I don't know what the fuck he did, but why the fuck you popping at this nigga, bro? You know I do business with his pop. You hear me talking, nigga?
Look, I feel all that. I feel it. But the bitch Sharia already told me that nigga was plotting on me.
He was plotting on y'all for a whole other nigga.
Hey, Trail. Hey, bruh. Let me holler at you real quick. Bruh, nigga, what you on? Nigga, I heard about that reckless shit you was talking to my ex-bitch Sharia, nigga.
Bitch, you gurping that bitch's name, nigga? She told me what you said, nigga. And I checked her ass that she sucked my dick, bitch.
Oh, is that right, nigga? Okay, well, check this out. I wouldn't give a fuck about none of that, nigga. But the next time you threaten
me,
I'm gonna air your ass out, nigga.
Well, say less then, nigga.
What is happening, dude? White out there, same a flyer. Rain Rover smashing through the V, smoking green clovers.
Headed to the ridge. Are you ready to honor the legacy of my brother and hip hop legend, Shock G, and make a difference in the community? Show your support for the East Oakland Collective, EOC, by purchasing the new Shock G Humpty T-shirt designed by Shamari Smith. It's available at beatsforhope.com. My brother Shock G was a multi-platinum hip-hop pioneer and producer who was deeply committed to helping the community, culture, and music of his time. His vision for helping humanity was honorable and has inspired people to come together and see to those that need important attention and love. By purchasing the new Shock G Humpty T-shirt, you are supporting the EOC, which helps provide essential services in East Oakland. Together we can make a difference as we honor Shock G's legacy and support our friends at the EOC. Get your Shock G Humpty T-shirt today.
What it do?
Police?
Police.
That's
General.
Live by the sword, die by the sword, has become a common expression, adapted from Jesus. Words to Peter, the proverb meaning is still basically the same. A person who lives violently will probably at some point be killed in a violent manner. Violence begets violence. Those who practice violence will come to a violent end. I say it again. Those who practice violence will come to a violent end.
I used to shoot all my videos with Hooker Boy.
The mechanics.
Yeah, I pull
up on the scene with a pocket full of green, and my shooter got the strap with the beam. Payroll is the team, watch me hit him with the screen and shoot the shot at your bitch for the three. If it's money in this bitch, wave your hands in the air. Pop a bottle, have a drink with a player. Sucker ducking, ducking suckers, I ain't fucking with the youngsters. Catch me on the flight walking through customs with a Mary's on. Top hat, a collar shirt, bitch, I'm really grown. Bad chick, a couple kids and a couple homes. Rap shit, who fucking with me when I'm in my zone? Point them out, I'm really on. And I don't think with my Peter, a bitch, I don't need her. Flow so sick, it got a fever. And these niggas say they rich, but they don't own shit. When I see them on the gram, I don't believe them. Penthouse.
I'm a stepper with my weapon. Top hat in my section. Shining, big time it. Money long. Sucker ducking. I'm a real one, a blessing. Took a nail, learned my lesson. When the haters hate, I ain't stressing. I've been long ago.
Designer lace shoes. When I step up in the room, two-stepping on you niggas, no jewels. They say I was a fool, how I make a bitch choose. Play it cool for you end up on the news. I'm from Oakland, California. Used to hustle on the corner, and I'm still chasing paper at the moment. Balenciaga runners, vacations for the summer. Big time and little nigga, I'm a stunner. On some cool shit, smooth shit. I like to hang out with a cool bitch. Slim thick, cute face on some boss shit. Flawless, these niggas thought I really lost it. Watch this, I don't miss. If it ain't about paper, we don't need to conversate. What your man for? Life's great. And you see me suck a duck and sliding on the interstate. If it ain't about cake, I can't relate.
Penthouse. I'm a stepper with my weapon. Top hat in my section. Shining, big time it. Money long, sucker ducking. A real one, a blessing. Took a nail, learned my lesson. From the haters, hey, I ain't stressing. I've been long ago, sucker ducking.
Hello, 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 and welcome to another edition of Mad Mondays. Thank everybody for tuning in on Twitch.tv/BayLifeRadio, as well as the other followers out there on Instagram and Facebook. We just want to say thank you. Today is Monday, the beginning of a new week. I hope everybody had a great Monday so far. I had a good Monday. Work was good. Work was good because I had a job to go to. Amen. Plus, I woke up, so I'm giving all the glory to the higher power. And then my second in order will be Little Big Cuss Igor Beats.
What it do?
What it do, Little Big Cuss?
What it do? What's happening with it?
Oh, man, good to see you.
Hey,
you
come
know
on.
What I'm saying?
We got about a dozen man, in, man. Shit. We about 12 deep in this season, man.
Man, come on,
come
man.
Come on, steady
oh,
giving
shit.
It to
it's
him.
It's almost season 5, Nina.
Right. You feel me? They better keep up.
For real, man. Shout out to everybody that has actually been a part of the Mad Mondays. If you had an interview, if we played your music, if we played showed your flyers, we definitely appreciate y'all for sliding through and showing us love because we showed y'all love. But Lil Big Cuz, man, how was your how has it been since last Monday?
Oh, it's been cool. It's been cool. It's been coasting by. You know, the artist retreat been cranking.
Yes, it
has. Tonight is a special show at the artist retreat.
Yes, it is.
Cause we finna mess with Funny.
Yeah, they you fucking with Funny tonight.
It's going down.
And I kind of fucked up on that bag because I should have.
Buy me.
I fucked up on that one. I dropped that bag, man.
I've been saying, but it ain't over though.
No, it ain't over.
But this is just a small.
Yeah, this is a little little taster, you know what I'm saying? A couple, a few comedians. I don't know the whole lineup of comedians, but it's supposed to be a few. I know Miss Canary, she'll be in the building. Lil Tone, my little cuss, he'll be there. Shit, I don't know who else. I don't know any there.
What's her name? Red Lip Bandit.
Oh, his girl.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's on there too.
Oh,
yeah,
shit.
She gonna be there.
Okay.
Andrea Nicole is performing live.
Okay, I seen that.
King Quayus is performing live.
Okay. Okay. So it's gonna be
It's
I see you got the What It Do shirt on. So yeah, Baylife will definitely be in the building.
You feel me? It's going down tonight.
Hell
yeah. Hey, you got live over here going crazy.
Is they going crazy? That's what's up. Shout out to everybody on the live one time, y'all.
Shout out to the Soul Singer. What's up, Nate?
Hell yeah, we need to get you up in here.
For sure.
On one of these Mondays. Real talk.
As a matter of fact, I got to get some more Ice Stevie flyers. They took all them yesterday.
Ice Stevie will be here next week. He was supposed to came today, but he tapped in and said he couldn't make it, family business. So
no, it's all good.
He'll
be
here next Monday.
Weeks,
yeah, we still got a couple of weeks. I just got my, well, I didn't actually get it, but the niggas, I got his word that I got all access to that G thing.
Oh, yeah, you better come on. Yeah, I had to get my tickets immediately.
Yeah, right.
I wasn't even going on nobody word.
So what date is that again? We got a flyer for that?
November 27th.
November 27th.
Yeah, I'm waiting on the official flyer, too.
That motherfucker might be sold out, because I know he said he had got 30 extra tickets, and he sold Dub, and that was last week.
So it sold out?
It sold out, then.
It sold out, because think about it. He had to get 30 more.
Right.
It's crazy.
And look, Butter was even like, she do shows at that motherfucker. Yeah, like, damn, you got 30 extra seats.
That's my crush.
And they got 30 extra seats, though. But shout out to you, Stevie, man, for all the followers to keep supporting that man. Shit, this is one of many shows, you know what I'm saying? If he did it for this one, then they going
to
be like, oh, yeah, this nigga bringing in money.
We
going
to
run that back.
Next.
Yeah,
we
going
to
Paramount.
Right.
Paramount.
Paramount. Yeah. Yeah, we got to have
a
Paramount.
I want the Paramount.
Right. Smoke out one of them dressing rooms.
Hell yeah, but shit, like, real. Talk. So man, it was a good fucking week though. Like, for real, it was a lot of shit going on this week.
Hey, you know what though?
Yeah.
It was some incredible shit going on this week.
It definitely
was. The writer's room.
You fucked me up with that one. I wasn't into that, but
yeah, you was.
Y'all did win when I saw a quarterback, so that was interesting.
Drop alone.
Yeah, that was interesting. The Niners lost their first one. That was interesting.
They can have him back.
Yeah, the Niners lost their first one.
That was crazy too.
Cleveland was talking that shit.
Right.
Before the game, you see the little fight before the game and shit.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, they was.
It went down though. That was a good ass game though. Good ass game.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie though. They had the Niners thugging.
Yeah. For
you
real.
Feel me? That was a side of the Niners I haven't seen.
Number 71 though, he with the shit.
Right.
I think that was the nigga that used to play for. I think he played for Cleveland when they fought. He used to play for Cleveland or Pittsburgh, I believe. But when them niggas had a fight, remember the nigga? Was fighting. And the nigga swung the helmet.
Right.
Hit the nigga in the head.
I know who you talking
about.
Yeah,
I think that nigga one of them boys. he was the shit. That nigga came over there and pushed that nigga hella hard. Like, nigga,
hella
back up.
Hella hard. Like, yeah, like, let's go.
And then Buffalo game last night, nigga, they went at it too. The Giants and Buffalo, they went at it, nigga.
Right?
The quarterback nigga even jumped in that shit and pushed the nigga hella hard. That shit was good, though. But we got to back up a little bit, though, because hella shit went on during the week.
You right.
You know what I'm saying? So we ended at the artist retreat. So that was Monday. And then you had anything Tuesday?
Nah, Tuesday.
Tuesday was dry last week?
Tuesday was dry.
Okay,
Wednesday was cool.
Wednesday was cool. It was another artist retreat.
It was a whole nother set. It's crazy how that's happening.
Right.
We're having a couple of same artists, but Monday and Wednesday
be different.
Bring different
supporters.
Yeah. I still be getting that Chefing with Shani bust down, though.
Matter of fact, whoa, she was supposed to have been on the motherfucker today. I knew it was somebody I forgot,
bro. Chefing with Shani?
Yeah.
Oh, Chefing with Shani was supposed to. That's
I didn't
crazy,
even know that was her, though.
Yeah, Twice was supposed to come this morning.
Yeah, I just seen him on Cognac Confessional. Shout out to my nigga D, Cognac Confessionals.
Last week,
y'all check him out every Friday on Cognac Confessionals. That's the actual hit that. On I believe on Facebook and YouTube,
Instagram Live.
Yeah, Instagram Live. And that's from what, 6 o'clock?
Six o'clock.
It's about 6 to 8. Check your shit out though. Tell them Two sent you. So what was that Thursday? So we stopped at Thursday. Then so that was Wednesday. So then Thursday was the boat cruise. I missed the boat cruise, but I might go this week. You know what I'm saying?
It's been cool.
I've been telling motherfuckers about it, and people
been
growing
to get
and,
off.
And having little birthday parties and shit though. So shout out to Blake. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he's been keeping it lit. He said he's going to ride it until the wheels fall off, until the weather start changing. So it's probably going to be a couple more before it's over. That's it's going to start raining around this motherfucker in a minute.
One. We got a special guest this Thursday, so I ain't gonna
I think I'm supposed to be on there, so I'm going to only make the 8 o'clock. Because I faked on last week.
Oh, that's right, because it come back in at 8:30.
It come back at
and you
it come back
the
eight.
Second one.
Yeah, you catch the second one.
Okay.
So we might have action today.
Might,
but yeah, I told her. What's her show called?
The Awfully Amazing Podcast.
Awfully
with
Amazing Podcast with Miss Tamara. That's every Thursday from what, 5 to 7?
Yep.
Okay, and then on Mondays, I got to retract because why it's on my mind right now. We got Sugar and Spice. They come on at 12 o'clock from 12 to 2. Shout out to the ladies, Canary and Andrea and Nicole. And then a couple hours later, you can catch the Unstoppable Stewards. Right. They show, shout out to them. They show us from 3 to 4. This is also Monday. And then I come in at 5 o'clock with the Mad Monday. So you got like a lot of entertainment. If you ain't doing shit or if you off or just at work, you know what I'm saying, and got a laptop or something, you actually got a whole fucking day of entertainment with different different shit. Like different shit really going on. But we still got a little big cousin in the spaceship keeping it lit with the videos and music. So it definitely goes down on Monday. But that was Thursday for Miss Tammy as well. So then Thursday was a boat cruise. I didn't really do shit Thursday. So then Friday, what you do Friday?
Arriba!
All
right, I was down at the Aloha Bar.
At the Aloha Bar. So he was at the Aloha Bar on Friday. Shit, I don't want to do shit. I think I was just in the streets fucking around and shit. So then Saturday, nigga. First of all, I want to give a shout out to the entire Castlemont High Knights. To the entire fucking school.
Right.
All classes, right. All ages, all genders. Salute to y'all. Salute to y'all. It was class of 84 to class of 96. They was up in there, man. They looked it good. I was making jokes on the mic and shit because I was the host. And I remember one time I was like, Blen, I don't even remember Castlemont having pretty girls, this many pretty young ladies at their school. You know what I'm saying? We knew them as Herbie High and all the other shit. I think I said that on the mic too.
Right. He said, they used to call this old school.
They used to call, that's what they did, though. Everybody know that shit. Nigga, right. They used to call Castlemont Herpy High.
Right.
I don't know where that shit came from, but I just do want to give a shout out to everybody that actually came. I want to give a big special shout out to Miss Keela Page for making that shit possible.
Overtime!
Yeah, for sure. You did your thing. You know what I'm saying? And she didn't have a committee. She did everything by herself. Everything looked it nice. Everything was set up just nigga like on some like some real nice shit. I don't even go to Castlemont, and I was like, oh, this is really nice, nigga. It was so nice that I went to my motherfucking Fremont High alumni pages today and tapped in and was like, man, I just hosted Castlemont shit and they shit was really nice. I think we need to do a all class reunion for it would only be right if we do it for our 30th, my 30th, class of 94. We do it next year, do it real big. Because everybody, all the whole AOL got motherfucking reunions and shit.
Right.
We ain't got shit, man.
Right.
We ain't got shit. So I think I might have sparked it up because niggas, I'm getting that shit was hitting today. Motherfuckers was in and doing surveys and hella shit. Though. So shout out to Fremont High as well, man. All my Fremont High folks out there. Just the whole OAL. Because I even gave a shout out to everybody, nigga. Even Dewey. We gave Edward Shands. We said Adele Day. I gave a shout out to everybody at the reunion, though. But Castlemont came and showed out, man. They came and showed out all years, like on some real shit. Right. Like for real, from 84 to. And motherfuckers really looked it good. And they was on the dance floor. Y'all
Miss
really
Keela
had them.
Woke the game up, though, table of candles.
Oh, yeah. I just seen Vail. Vail was just talking about it on their show. That was dope. And it was love. And she said that wasn't even all the candles because she don't have everybody's information. You feel me?
Right.
But for those people that she did have.
That was a full table
Two full tables. Nigga, I went live. I did a live on the shit. And, nigga, that got, like, more hits than any of the other lives that I went, bro. Because they seen that shit and was like, damn.
That was impactful,
that
man.
Idea was dope. Like, my reunion that I've been to, I've seen, you know what I'm saying, motherfucker do, like, a video thing.
Yeah. Yeah,
but I ain't never seen no shit like that.
That candles, that was live in your face.
Yeah, with the picture and when they pass and all this shit, blood, that was dope as fuck. Like, for real, that was dope as fuck.
She put in a lot of work.
Yeah, she put in hella work. And she said she did it all by herself, man. So once again, Miss Keela, shout out to you. You did your motherfucking thing. I might need her to help us plan our shit.
Right.
Shout out to her brother, Dame, too. Dame the Barber, you know what I'm saying? He nigga. Hey, Fremont was in the building, nigga. They had a dance off and shit. That shit was hella funny, blood. That shit was cool. Then we had MC Pooh Man perform. You know what I'm saying? And then my nigga Boss Man went to Castle Mine, so it was only right that we had that nigga perform. And he didn't rip that shit. So, man, yeah, that shit was fun. You know what I'm saying? Everybody had a good time. I see a lot of feedback. I see a lot of pictures. So everybody had a good time, blood. And I like seeing that. That's what I like seeing. You know what I'm saying? Black people coming together. Nigga, no matter the age, motherfuckers don't even know each other. Some people didn't even go to school with each other, but just coming into one building and just having fun.
No problem.
Yeah, no problems. I ain't heard of no cars getting bipped yet. Nothing, you know what I'm saying? So everybody got home safe. I ain't heard about nobody getting nothing happening. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, thank you, Oakland. Thank you, OAL. Thank you, Keela, for making me a part of it. Shout out to Square and shout out to Bum Bailey. B Bailey.
B Bailey.
B Bailey. Shout out to him. He was downstairs keeping it in the mix.
Lit.
So, yeah, man, it was lit. Shout out to Jeffries for still having an establishment, a black-owned establishment in Oakland, California for all these motherfucking years. It's still open. So we want to say thank you to Mr. Jeffrey. We definitely appreciate you. Real talk. Yeah, man, that shit was fun. That shit was fun. Yeah, so I guess we wrapped everything up for the first segment of this shit. We're going to go to the break for a few commercials, a few videos, and we'll be back, man. This is Mad Mondays.
I am Daryl Allums. I'm executive director of Adam and Gavilla Stopping Our Kids Movement. I'm also the founder of the Oakland Frontline Healers. Oakland Frontline Healers are an Oakland, California service in African American community that's impacted by the COVID-19 crisis right now. We are on the front line every day, passing on masks, hand sanitizer, giving groceries, taking our loved ones, getting tested, out here serving our community while the pandemic is going on. Oakland Frontline Healers is also supporting our loved ones have dealt with community gun violence, police violence, domestic violence, and any violence that's tapped onto that. We're here to support our community however we possibly can.
Big, big, big. Big, big, big. Big, big. Big, 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 big. Cheese on the swag. Big, big, cheese on the swag.
Them hustles had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Came a long way because I stepped it up. Hanging with them hustles had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Yeah, I came a long way because I stepped
my
it up.
My little Riddler, fresh out that tuna can in Santa Rita. And when he rock, he only roll with the two-seater. Mix the folk, it's only with the 2 liter. Max Payne, hammer down and I'm talking 2 heaters. Speak no evil, you probably won't see none. Cause Lil Rilla, really bring a mop, you wanna see some? Fuck the other side and the rest, how they did it. He done ran with the best that did it and got away with it. Lick boy up on this game cause he a big rapper. For Lil Witty Saxon, boy he a big stepper. Anything up in this way, you getting repped on. By money, your family, you getting stepped on. Cuddy, he a road runner. Cold gunner, he a pole clutcher. Got that Cinnabon, he let it blow. And pull a plug and let it drain like a runny nose.
Hanging with them hustlers, had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Came a long way because I stepped it up. Hanging with them hustlers, had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Yeah, I came a long way
because I stepped it up.
Stayed down and I came up. Went down, ain't say nothing. Went broke like plenty time. About my space, they gon' give me mine. Came up on that black top. Old school, still pushing rocks. Didn't know about the water whipping, but Lord knows I know now. Never whip worked up in the joint. I'm a bougie nigga, need a Pyrex. Ain't worried about who got next. Cause in the streets, I'm right now. Stayed down and I came up because I stepped up like a big dog. Stayed down and I came up because I stepped up like a big dog. You
them hustles had to step it up. Started out with the doubled up, yeah, I bubbled up. Started out a current server, quickly came to top burner. Rude boy, top shot of hood, my father, fuck stay, bring a nigga two losses. Head bust a nigga for the right dollar. Hanging with them hustles had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Came a long way because I stepped it up. Hanging with them hustles, had to step it up. Started at the bottom, but I stepped it up. Mama still need that house, I gotta step it up. Yeah, I came a long way because I stepped it up.
Are we on the air?
Yes, you are.
You're live in the mix with the one and only.
One and only.
DJ Igor Beats.
I'm your host, Whiteout, a.k.a. Two Man. You already know what it is. And our first guest for the this evening is a young man that I met about a week ago. Huh? Wasn't even a week ago. Maybe 5-6 days ago. And, you know, I was talking to his moms. Shout out to mom. She in the building. You want to be seen right quick, or are you just saying, hey? So I was talking to moms, and she was like, you know what I'm saying, talking about her son. And she was like, yeah, my son makes music, and I was like, oh, okay, that's what's up. That's what's up. You make your music, what? I was like, yeah. He was like, yeah, I make music. So then I actually, I don't know if she told you this, though, but she played the birthday song y'all made for her. And I was like, okay. I heard the music. She played a couple of your beats and shit. And I was like, okay. Young Blaze, you kind of dope. You know what I'm saying? Not kind of dope, but you are dope. And you young, and you doing this shit. So I was like, man, yeah, I'm going to bring you to the podcast and shit. We're here on a Monday. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I just know you as Eric, but I want you to introduce yourself and let everybody know. All the way from Oakland, California, please show him some love. This is Eric, y'all. Oh! Rewind. I'm tripping. My bad. See, I be that weed, and I'm getting old, too. Yeah, he corrected me. It's not Eric. It's Kevin. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Kevin. I'm glad you didn't hit me, man. Like, I said my name was Kevin. My bad, brother. My bad. And I just asked you before that, too. I should have knew that. Shame on me. Welcome, brother. Thank welcome. You, welcome. How you doing?
I'm
I'm doing good.
You doing good? You're a humble young brother. That's one thing I like about you, too. My spirit told me that you're a young, humble brother. So for the people that don't know you on Twitch TV, just tell them who you are, what you do, and what you got going on right now, brother.
My name is Kevin Cozine.
Talking
my
to the mic a little bit.
Producer name is Will KC. I'm 21, born and raised Oakland, California. I've actually been producing for a year. I'll say only reason I say a year because I started like a couple of years ago, and it's just like I stopped doing it, and then I went into this little program. It's called Dev Mission, and they had a program where it helps kids make beats and stuff like that, get the fundamentals of it, and ever since that I did that back in 2022, and ever since that I've just been producing a lot of beats and stuff like that. Just from the help that they gave me and just from the knowledge of, like, videos I was watching. And then, not recently, or last year, the same program, what is it called? I actually got a job with them. So, now, right now, I'm a teacher, and I help kids make beats.
That's dope. Damn, you did all that in 1 year?
Yeah.
That's crazy. Look at God. He wanted you to be that teacher. He wanted you to be in that place and help kids. So you helping kids make beats?
Yes.
No shit? How you like that?
I like it a lot. Like, yeah. It's cool seeing how I was during them making it and then just seeing them do their own little styles and stuff like that. It's just real cool to me.
Right, because it's going to be the next sound. You never know. The next sound might be coming from one of them ones that you actually teaching right now. But you said you only been making beats for 1 year?
Recently. Well, not recently. I shouldn't say recently, but just like... Now, since from last year to now, yeah, it's been like a year since I've been making beats.
So you just never kinda, play? You never play like instruments and nothing?
Oh, I did like when I was little, like in church playing the drums.
I knew you was a church guy. I knew it. So you used to play church? Oh, for real? Did you get little girlfriends and stuff because you played drums? No.
No.
Didn't nobody like the drummer?
You
don't want to say it because your mama here? You grown now, nigga. No, but for real, though. How did you like that, though?
I liked it a lot. It's just, what is it called? I think just for me, when growing up, I kind of, it's not like I stopped loving drumming. I still like it. Mm-hmm. But it's just, I stopped doing it. And now, like, producing, it's just basically like, it's like the same thing now.
It's like drums 2.0.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Right. So, for the people that were looking at the commercial or have been watching since we have been on air, the song that you heard prior to us coming on, that was one of his hits. Do you have, like, since you don't have, like, people rapping on none of your songs, do you, like, still make names for them?
Yeah.
Oh, for real? Like, so, what was the name of that one?
That one was called Obstacle. I got it from a loop from a different producer, but I put drums on it and then did my own little thing, like, rearranging the whole loop and stuff like that.
Right. Have you ever sold a beat?
Yes, I have.
For real, how much you sell for it, if you don't mind me asking?
I sell, sometimes the price of changes, it depends on, there's a thing called Wave and MP3.
Okay.
So, MP3 is like 15.
15 what?
$15.
That's it?
Yeah.
Ah, you need to sell your shit for a little bit more, man. Fuck that, 50 and up. What you think, little bit, cuz? What's the lowest a nigga can? That's too low, though. Fuck that, nigga. I got a beat, nigga. You might fuck around and go platinum on my shit and only made $15? I'll be hella mad. It happened? Yeah, some niggas might just steal your shit, huh? Uh-huh. Nigga, like, wait a minute, nigga, that was my beat. Right. So you have sold beats?
Yes.
For real? That's cool. Have you heard them, like, have you heard the songs, like, after you sold the beats to the people? Like, have you heard your shit, like, would rap on it or whatever?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
How it be sounding?
It be sounding good.
You be juiced, though, huh? Because that's like, yeah, that's my shit right there. That's what's up. So where you make your beats at?
At home.
Oh, so you got all the shit at home?
Mm-hmm.
So I you a computer dude, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, I noticed that day when you helped her hella quick. Like, boo-boo, when you did that shit hella quick, I was like, oh, just digging over my computers. So, yeah. So it was easy for you to...
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Like, it took time to, like, learn it and stuff like that, because at first I was just like, nah, this is too complicated and stuff like that. And then I just said, nah, I'll keep doing it, watching videos, see how people do it.
So videos help.
They help a lot.
So I'll be telling people what, on YouTube?
Yes.
YouTube is the shit. You can ask YouTube for anything you want to learn, and they will teach you, for real. I went one time, I had a BMW, and it was hella hard to, like, change the light bulb. And they showed me, and I was like, hell no, I ain't going to be able to do that shit. I got to take that to a shop. That was too much shit for me to have to do, though. But it did teach me how to do it. Like, for real. You'd be surprised what you type of, and they got a video for that shit. Damn, you said 1 year. Where you want to go with it? What you want to do? You want to be the next Dr. Dre, or what you want to do?
Something like that.
Yeah. So are you going to continue teaching kids as well?
Yeah.
Yeah. One day you might have your own school. Mm-hmm. That would be dope. For real. No, in Oakland too?
It's in San Francisco.
I'm saying to have yours in Oakland. Yeah. That would be dope.
That'd be real good.
What high school you went to?
I went to from 9th to 11th grade, I went to Lionel Wilson.
Lionel Wilson had a school?
Brownie Park.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
In some Brandy?
Yeah.
What school? Madison?
No. Lionel Wilson. Lionel Wilson private
school. Oh, but it's in some Brandy, though?
Yeah.
Oh, for real?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's what's up. I didn't even know that. How you liked it there?
I liked it. It was good. And then during my 12th grade year, I moved to a school called Freedom High School.
I heard of Freedom.
Oakley, California.
Yeah, I heard of Freedom.
Yeah, I moved out there.
I think they had a good football team or something. They used to be on TV back in the day. Okay. How you like that?
I liked it. It was way different. Just like from going to a whole charter school and then going to like a public school.
Yeah.
Just like seeing all the people, whole different environment.
Right. Oh, so the charter school, you had to wear a uniform and shit.
Yep.
So then the school.
And then I get to learn.
Wear whatever you want. Oh, yeah. So that's different. Like, hell yeah, my mom could have been doing this shit. That's what's up, man. So if somebody wanted to buy some music from you, where would they have to go? Do you have music like online where they can hear it and be like, I like that shit. Can I buy that?
That's what I'm trying to do.
Okay.
It's, what's it called? It's a website called BeatStars. I'm trying to get it set up and stuff like that. Just so you put your beats on there. They can buy it and stuff like that, and then you get like the money like right away.
Okay, well shit, shit. People on here, I know a little bit, cuz probably got some info for you too. You know what I'm saying? Far as to help you with that, but shit, I just say keep doing your motherfucking thing, but definitely charge more than $15. Go to 25. Go to 25 at least, or give them a dub. Like give them three for three. Give them a jug, right? Yeah. 4 for $150 or some shit. Make them think they got a deal and be like, damn, that sounds like a deal. Let me get 4 of them. We got another song for him. Now we gonna go into another song. He don't know the name of it, I'm pretty sure. Or do you know the name of the song?
I probably do.
You could tell
like
us
when
after
I,
then.
When I hear it,
And what's your because I heard you say it, but what's your DJ name?
Woe KC.
Huh?
Woe KC.
Woe KC?
Uh-huh.
How you spell it?
W-H-O-A.
Woe.
Like,
KC.
There's like.
Woe KC. Yeah, okay. Woe KC. So do you put a DJ in front of it?
Mm-mm.
No? That's too old for you?
No,
That's too old school. He said, Woe KC. That's it. I don't need no DJ in front of my shit. Woe KC. We'll give it up for Woe KC. This is the next one of his. Damn, scared the shit out of me. I'm like, that's how that nigga song started. Nigga, this bomb right here. Here you go. But yeah, here we go. Let's check it out. We go to some flyers.
Dreamer.
Dreamer?
Yeah.
This one right here is called Dreamer. Thank you. wish I was a rapper, nigga. I was would have busted that right quick. that could go both ways though. That could be a rap song. That could be a R&B song. What type of music do you make for, like, who do you make the most for? Like, is it a certain?
I mostly make the most for hip hop, which is kind of like, not like, it's not like, to me, it's not bad, but I try to get into other genres like R&B a little bit.
As you should, brother.
And then trying to, like, sometimes I try to, like, mix them together and, like, try to just come up with something different.
Always. Yeah. Because, I mean, that just listening to that last beat, it sounded like somebody who fucked with the Timberland producer. You know what I'm saying? Somebody that like make you, you know, some beats just make you bob your head slow, and then some of them make you bob your head fast and shit because you catching that. That's what that reminded me of though. But you say rap for the most part.
Yeah.
So yeah, go country. Remember I was talking about that shit. I'm like, man, fuck that. You need to make everything. You make all kind of music shit because everybody will buy your shit. Rock and roll, fuck with the girl, all that shit. For real, yeah. Keep doing your thing. No, where can they find you at on social media? Do you do social media?
Yeah,
you do. Where can they find you at on social media if they wanted some more info on you?
Oh, shit.
How many pages you got? Hello. Oh, just one?
One. Actually, I have two.
What you be on? You be on IG or
mostly? Yeah, mostly IG.
You be on Facebook too? See, why the youngsters don't even do Facebook? You just make me feel hella old. You make me feel like Facebook is MySpace.
It's not like Facebook is bad. It's just like, I don't really be on there like that.
No, whatever one didn't work. As long as you're on one of them.
Because I used to be begging my mama to get a Facebook. And once I got it, I just didn't use it.
Oh, yeah. Because you didn't want her all in your business. I understand. Because my mama stay in my shit. Like, damn, mama, you tripping. This is my page. I'm a grown-ass man. Mind your business.
It's Whoa_KC, WHOA_KC.
Okay. You want to give a shout out to anybody?
Shout out to one of my friends. He just released an album that I co-produced on.
Oh, for real?
Uh-huh. His name is Chris Alo.
Okay. Tell him to tap in. We got his music?
Uh-uh.
No, you don't got your... All right, well, yeah. Where are you from?
He from L.A.
Okay. You produce this whole shit or just one out? I mean, so.
Just like, I co-produced like two songs.
Oh, for real?
Uh-huh.
And it's out? Where can they find that at?
On SoundCloud.
Okay. What's the name of that?
It's,
Plug it.
The...
Yeah, take your time, brother. That's all we got is time right now. My other guests ain't here, so we chilling. Thank y'all for tuning in. Oh, you can also call in, too, 510-563-7819. I forgot we had the phone line. Once again, 510-563-7819.
It's his first ever EP. It's called In Her Dreams.
Okay. What's his name?
Chris Alo.
How you spell it?
C-R-I, and then the S is dollar sign, and A-L-L.
A-L-L?
A-L-O.
Oh, what is it, Alo?
Chris Alo.
Chris Alo. Yeah. Okay, got you. Chris Alo. Mm-hmm. What nationality is that? What is he?
He's Mexican.
Mexican?
Yeah.
Okay, see. What do you do, though? Like, is he rapping?
Yeah, he raps.
For real? He dope? For real? I'm going to have to check him out. You're going to have to send that to me so I can check him out. You said on Spotify?
On SoundCloud.
SoundCloud,
yeah, and Spotify.
Okay.
Spotify and Apple Music.
Do you have anything on? Like, well, shit, you don't put beats on Spotify, do you?
Mm-mm. Well, it's not
just
like...
your birthday song?
Yeah.
You want to play the birthday song one time? You got the birthday song, bud? You tired that song?
It's not like I don't like it. It's just from how many times I had to
fix it and
hear it
over
again. It's just like, yeah.
That shit crazy because I've been in like the studio when people make albums. And that shit takes a lot, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? That shit takes a lot. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You got takes, and if you mess up, you got to re-record. Yeah, you got to sound like the same person again on the second take or third take. That shit might take forever. How long do it take for you to make a beat?
I'll say like 30 minutes.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So you kind of like the white dude on what's that movie, bud? Hard Out Here for a Pimp.
Oh, the movie that's based off of...
What's that shit called, though? What was that shit called? Oh, Hustle and Flow. Remember how you made that one beat? Don't, don't, don't. Then he started doing that shit. But he made that hella fast, though. It's like, damn, this nigga made that shit. And that shit slapped, though. That was my shit. Whoop that trick. Nigga, that beat go crazy. That boom, 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 boom. Yeah, that shit was tight. That shit was tight. But it's all about you right now, brother. We got another one on the way out. You said that's the only person you wanted to give a shout out to, brother?
Shout out to my mom.
Okay, I was finna say, damn, nigga, she in here. Hey, these artists be killing me. They be with their parents and don't get their parents shit. I be like, yo, it's cold. You wouldn't even know about this podcast if it wasn't for your mama. Shout out to moms, though, for real, some real shit. We're gonna have to have you back, bro. Like, we're gonna have to have you come back. You got some, well, we gonna network with you so Igor can play your music, like, during his shit. You know, he play music during the day.
Yeah.
But, like, if you have anything coming up, any new, I mean, like, new shit coming out, new music, shows, anything, just tap in with us and let us know. Or have moms call us, tap in with us, you know what I'm saying, flyers, whatever you got, you know what I'm saying. Or you can just pull back up and holler at us. It's all good. We definitely appreciate you, brother. Keep doing your thing, man. You know
Thank
what I'm
you
saying?
Again, I appreciate
yeah,
it.
Yeah, most definitely, most definitely. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time. I was going to say Kevin, but it's Woe MC, right?
KC.
Woe KC. Look out for him on some real shit. I might even have him make my next comedy song. News at 11. We'll be back after these messages.
Dangerous Dame, old school pool man, fucking with Dame, pimp of the year, other day in the alleyway, but slut of delinquents. I'm talking real tail business when you mention these niggas. I'm on my DB Stokely, Black Dynasty shit. I'm off that Tony Toe while I'm fucking your bitch. Got your daughter's funky expedition, that was the shit. I'm knocking F and Blue, Oakland style, riding the strip. That shot cheap, money B, Humpty Hump shit. I'm a town nigga, y'all know what the fuck that it is. MC Hammer can't touch this, rest in peace, Gates to Pete. Father Dom J. Dub, rest in peace, Plan B. D Lo don't trust a hoe, and Filthy say fake love. Jay Stallion and that Live Wire nigga, Lil Blood, Cookie Money, Zoda Rose, MAC, Mac Blast. Rest in peace, L Dog, shout out Capital Tags. It's Sonny, AK Goldie, that's the land to fuck. This Oakland, baby, ain't nobody fucking with us. Shout out to Fabby Davis, he been holding it down. He got that dope barrel movement floating on through the town. TMB, Lil Mikey, Lil Cuz on the road. G Easy, Kamaya, and Keisha Cole. Trill Youngins, all black, Lil Junior, he go. EA Ski, and Banks, I can't forget to show. Dame Dollar in this bitch, representing for show. Trailblazing in Portland, why he repping the O? Last but not least, it's the Fabulous Four. FMLE, the next niggas ready to blow. YOG, E16, that shit is a go. El Coca, Black Culture, that shit is some dope. Big Vito, the wait is over, he in the zone. Boss Man, Mr. 100, I'm about to take over. Ain't no love in these streets, man, my city is cold. I'ma represent for the east, the west, and the north. Yeah, So Oakland, bitch. You gotta be from the town, know this shit I'm talking about, nigga. Straight up, nigga. I'm from that era, nigga. Gangsters and players, niggas. You know what I'm saying? Hustlers, nigga. You know what I'm saying? We get money around here, man. I don't know what y'all doing over there. You feel me? Tell business. East Oak. Cherry till I die, nigga. FMLE, bitch. Boss Man. Mr. 100.
Run it.
Hey. D-Wiz. So we really came from none reason chasing this money. There a nigga takes off from me, racing little buddy. All I know is chase a bag, nigga. I been getting told, little nigga better stand for some, nigga kill for none. Ain't no playing with no nigga, we do the creeping when it's static. Niggas talking about a bag, bitch, I been knew how to stack. It's on the floor, we make it happen, see them niggas in the static. Don't fuck with niggas, they be capping. Ain't really living what they rapping. Bitch, I been a real nigga, stand up nigga, ain't no capping it. Said he on us when he see his pussy, make it happen, yeah. Stack it back and blow it back and do that shit again. Freak, bitch, she tryna fuck the team because she heard we lit. Think we ain't better come see it, about to leave a nigga cook.
Baby, I just want a baby, be dumb and do bands. Baby, I ain't had shit, well, bitch, I'm the man.
Something soft in all depths, hard to fit in these pants. We don't fuck with niggas, they know what we on. Ayy, bitch, we buzz down, the fuck is right stones. It's the ice, don't believe in liking, you know we keep pose. Niggas copping, please, up and read us, and they don't want smoke. Wipe a nigga nose under pressure, he fold. Bitch, I know the road, I'm bringing it home. I'ma stack this shit for Ace, they said that he on. Ayy, push up on this load, I'm getting him gone. So really came from none reason, chasing this money. There a nigga takes off from me, racing little buddy. All I know is chase a bag, nigga, I been getting told. Little nigga better stand for some, nigga, kill for none. So you really came from none reason, chasing this money. There a nigga takes off from me, racing little buddy. All I know is chase a bag, nigga, I been getting told. Little nigga better stand for some, nigga, kill for none. Do it, nigga. Do the creeping when it's static. Yeah. Then it's static. Yeah.
The greatest scam I ever ran was convincing myself that I didn't need my mama to grow up. I had to take care of my family, my grandma, my brothers, and my sister. I was just a kid trying to raise kids. And when it came to finessing, I was a genius.
Usually sell this many gift cards.
We're youth pastors with the Neon Genesis Evangelical First Episcopal Baptist Irish Catholic Church of Douglas T. McKenzie.
Mm-hmm.
So just gonna do some gift card purchases to give out in the raffle.
You can slide whenever.
My mama's side is Filipino and my daddy's side is black. Not everyone accepted us. I didn't know I was supposed to behave a certain way because of how I looked. The truth is, I grew up and became my mama because she was a survivor and we were survivors.
God is good. God is great. Let us thank you for our food. Amen.
I'm
a stoop kid. I've seen everything on it. If you never moving, they gonna catch your ass.
Gomez out here with the Lava May folks. These folks are doing a great job and a great service to the community for those folks out there that are homeless, and not even the homeless. I mean, there's a lot of folks that are using this that aren't homeless, right?
It's true, yeah. There's a lot of low-income folks or folks that are housed in places where maybe the showers don't work or they're unsavory or maybe they're not a private or not always hot. So we do serve primarily houseless folks on the street.
Now, folks taking a shower, they don't want to get back in their dirty clothes. Is there an option for them to get some clothes at all here? I don't know.
We do have clothing donations. You know, it's all donation-based, so the stock fluctuates. But we do have a lot of volunteers or even community members that bring clothes out. So we typically do stock underwear and socks always. We got goods.
Oh, nice. So yeah. If you guys got some socks, you guys care to donate, you got some extra shirts. You know, we all outgrow our shirts. I'm into a 3X now, so I got to donate my 2Xs. But, yo, get down there and connect lavamay.org and make your donations.
So if you want to help out, you can do it right now by purchasing one of these shirts here. Go to beatsforhope.com.
Leave his on. And get one of these Beta LA Lava Mae shirts. All proceeds are going to be going right here to LavaMae.org organization. Thank you for your time. Thank you. Yep. Appreciate you so much.
Thanks for coming.
Right now we need some la-la.
Smoke. Mr. Fluid give it to you, don't it taste like dope? Murder he wrote, every time I pick up a pen and apply it to a pad, assassinating again. I got balls of adamantium, I'm the ish, and in a minute all my critics gonna be having a fit. Can't settle for nothing less than a boss's life. Hustle every single second for my boss's stripes. Keep my game tight, live a sort of hectic life. Juggle my business all day, but I ride at night. Daredevil, yeah, I'm kinda the adventurous type. Mouthpiece of a beast, I'm a Mac for life. You know we working with the best of the best. Mama taught me how to hustle, guess she spoiled me to death. Super fly, do or die, get my money in check. And before you waste my time, just write me a check. Yeah.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah. You know we're getting good things, pop things, pop. Get whatever I want, spoil ride.
Spoil ride.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah. You know we're getting good things, pop good things, pop. Get whatever I want, spoil ride.
Spoil ride.
Like money, huge appetite, but you don't hear my tummy. Every day Christmas, wrap it up for me. Black and Peruvian, back it up for me. Sex game stupid, head go dummy. Big rock in my ear and the wrist so stubby. Deep in the east where it gets so gully, and them haters gon' hate, but I'm doing love. Bottles on tap, perp on speed down, candy on the whip, make the pussy go see now. V-I-G, I live notorious. Lobster with hoes, steak with warriors. Check though, checkmate, I'm the king. On the throne, about to get crowned by my queen. I don't like shit, I be doing the fool. Spoil like milk, getting catered to.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah, you know we're getting good things, popping, popping. Whatever I want, spoil ride.
Spoil ride.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah, you know we're getting good things, popping, popping. Whatever I want, spoil ride.
Paparazzi flashing cameras, cause I'm super ultra. Living like a hustler, gotta love this culture. Big Daddy came swagging, operate so smooth. You never catch me half-stepping when I enter a room. Use this game like a broom, sweep you off of your feet. Me tweeting racks in the building, now your life's complete. Remember, flossing is the way, that's an old town anthem. Still my way of living, got me pimping like a champion. Sorry ladies, but I'll never ever be a captain. Twist the game a little, make y'all pay me for some action. Fly guy, just might hit your ride on an Aster. Roy, kiss the ring and bow down, respect the master.
You know we just spoiled to death. Yeah, you know we just spoiled to death. Me and Rex, we just spoiled to death. Yeah, you know we just spoiled to death.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah, you know we're good things, pop things, pop. Whatever I want, spoil ride.
Spoil ride.
You know we always out to get more.
Get more.
Fresh cars, fly women, the best clothes.
Best clothes.
Yeah, you know we're good things, pop things, pop. Whatever I want, spoil ride.
What it do?
I visit your city, it's just like home.
I'm fucked up. Y'all are just reading. He's waking up in the hospital now, and
you know, I can make a whole lot of shit crumble, bruh.
It's him, that nigga over the bench.
Word on the street is this nigga PJ riding around telling motherfuckers I done killed Corey. My nigga. You feel what I'm saying?
Okay.
I need you to take care of PJ.
I don't know, be playing, man. Tell him, you know, we're trying to make something happen, though, so nigga ain't got too much time to be waiting on.
I'm gonna get the white bitch on it.
What white bitch?
White bitch I took from Joe.
See, that's the shit I be talking about, man. It's what? Always something bigger with your plan.
You know that bitch?
Mm-hmm.
But the bitch don't know me.
Really had to tell you, though, right? That nigga PJ ain't cool, bro.
What are you doing?
That nigga out here selling that fake shit, that stepped on shit, and he's saying he getting it from us.
Lights out. Paying a fucking price, bitch.
Break a nigga down.
down like a Tyson punch. Keep it on my lap cause they be doing too much. Little ass nigga tried to give me some game. I heard the nigga out but I'ma stay in my lane. I've been touching paper like a money machine. Rockin' 24-7, I'ma leave with the ring. I don't sneak this niggas, you are not in my league. I'm the star player, Jordan, some you can never achieve. Press a nigga fast like I work at the cleaners. Beat a nigga ass like I'm Mike and you Tina. Told me dig deep so I dug up a body. I'ma sit on you niggas like I sat on a potty. Old bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Throw that nigga in the dump with a trash hat. We go to war, we turn it up like Baghdad. Sit aside for my bail. All naughty ass neighbors, how you stuck in a cell. But I'ma play my cards like a pinochle game. Pinochle be all up right in the head, cast a killing your brain. Old scary ass nigga scared to catch him a body. Running around acting like he don't know who shot him. Tell a bitch, don't buzz like she stuck in a picture. Crip the blood out of bitch, she gon' need it some stitches. If I slide on a nigga, I'ma slide on my lonely. Never telling on myself like most of your homies. Old bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Pull up on the scene in that 2022. I'ma run the race, I'ma leave with that W. 12 told me to keep pushing. Most of you niggas out here be dusting. Pussy boy soft as a piece of fucking cotton. Tell that pussy boy quit motherfucking spotting. Red bottom rocking, can't nobody stop this. They gon' have to knock this, no matter if they knock it. Stepping on a nigga like some boots up in the army. Underground clip on any nigga who want it. I'ma keep it cool like some ice up in the freezer. Melt a nigga down like an oven cooking pizza. Old bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga. Bitch ass nigga, I'm a rich ass nigga. You a snitch ass nigga, I don't fuck with you nigga.
And we're back. This is Mad Mondays. I'm your host, Whiteout, aka 2. Yeah, we're gonna let the clapping stop. So we played a couple extra videos, you know what I'm saying, because we was waiting on our next guest to pull up in our limo and shit, and she just pulled up, and we just got her in here and sat down, you know what I'm saying? She just got finished making some money, you know what I'm saying? It was like, shit, hold on right quick. Give me a minute. I'm like, all right, shit, take your time. My next guest, I had the pleasure to actually seeing her last week at the Artist Retreat. I'm telling you, the Artist Retreat is kind of dope because, you know what I'm saying, you can go in there as a supporter, or you can go in there as a scouter, or you can go in there just to hear good music from people that you don't know. And I just had the opportunity to hear her little self gassing and shit. I'm like, who the fuck is this little lady gassing on the mic and shit? So after she was over and shit, you know what I'm saying, I went and hollered at her, tapped in. And she was hella humble, you know what I'm saying, and was talking to me, gave me the little 411 and tapped in. And I was like, man, I need to have you on my show. And she like, it's all good. So without further ado, is she from the town?
I ain't from the town.
Where you from?
I'm from Richmond.
Oh, my bad. I do not want to get part. Shot in here. No, but shit, she's from the Richmond. It's bay business at the end of the day. Hey, no, but no. I think that's what made me think of that shit on some real shit, because you was like, you from Richmond. I'm like, damn, who you here with? And he was like, I'm by myself. And I'm like, shit, I know you got a pistol with this motherfucker somewhere. Your little self can't be here by yourself in Richmond. Oh, fuck that. Where the pistol? I know the pistol around this motherfucker somewhere. And then you got this nigga here. I don't know. He the nigga with the pistol right now and shit. I know y'all didn't come way out here with no guns, nigga. Fuck out of here. I know what it is. But excuse me, sweetheart. I didn't mean to fuck your city up like that. Shout out to Richmond, California. All the way from Richmond, California. And I'm going to say her name right because I don't want to get shot, nigga. Give it up for Miss Big Peso.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for coming, baby.
White out. That's Bay Life family right there.
Okay. See? Yeah, Bay Life. Shout out to the Bay. Shout out to the Rich, though. Shout out to the Rich, for sure. My mama used to work out there. Let me clear this shit up. My mama used to work at Montgomery Wards for like 20 years. She did hair. And then I used to go to the boys' club, so I went to Camp Mendocino with a lot of them niggas that played for Richmond Steelers. So shout out to Richmond.
She did hair.
Hell yeah.
I do hair. That's
I know.
Okay.
So Miss Big Peso, for the people that don't know who you are, you here, we?
Of course.
For the people that don't know who you are, tell the people in Twitch TV land who you are and what you got going on for the rich.
Well, my name is Peso. I am an artist, okay? I sing and I rap. You know, I also do hair as well. As of right now, I do have 3 singles out, One Night, Rain, and Something New. So far as music, I've been doing music since I was a child, but I didn't start taking it serious till 2023. My unk got me in the studio for the first time, and once I hopped on a mic, I never stopped. So we're going to keep it going.
So you say you did music. You did music before this year. So what kind of music was you doing then?
I was mainly rapping. Like, my dad could play you a song from when I was like 8 years old.
For real?
What this Christmas rhyme? I was really trying to do that. Like,
so that was a Christmas song.
Uh huh.
For real?
I made a Christmas song. I was like 8 years old.
Hell no.
Then of course, like, you know, that was us always writing, just writing. Then I got to high school when I had my little iPod. I was writing in my notes. Mm. Lost that phone, so I had to start all over again, and then I finally started, you know, rapping around people.
Okay.
And it was like, this sound tight. You might as well take this serious. And it sparked the idea in my head, and I started taking it serious, and I liked it.
Yeah, and you good at it, like, for real. On some real shit, I was like, damn, like, for real. And so how many years have you actually been rapping? You said, since eight, but you took it serious this year?
For sure, I would say high school, because I was making, like, little videos and stuff and putting them on Instagram. So freshman year, that was, like 2016.
Okay, so, like, yeah, so 8 years, eight years. What high school you went to?
I went to Hercules High my first 2 years, and then I went to Vallejo my last 2 and graduated.
Okay, for sure. What year you come out of?
2020.
Damn, make me feel old as fuck. I'm class of 94. Do the math. But you only 21, all right?
Well, 21 October 27th.
Okay, sure. Your birthday coming up, so if I don't see you again, happy birthday. What's that, Libras?
Scorpios.
Oh, shit. Here come the nasty ones.
No,
not you, but you know the Scorpios. What they say about Scorpios. Oh, so it's almost y'all season. Okay, that's what's up. So you've been really doing this shit for a year now.
Yeah, for sure. I've been doing it for a year now.
So have you been hitting stages? Because you rock that stage with ease. Like, you did that shit like you've been here before.
That's something good to hear, but honestly, I would say my first performance was at the Shop Studios in Richmond, California. My friend invited me to an artist networking event.
Okay.
And basically, you know, they had a couple rooms, different producers, and they was doing ciphers, you know, collabing, doing interviews. So my friend just kept on pushing the issue, like, when I was there, you know, just having me network, and right. I ended up performing.
That's what it's about, the network. That's why you here.
Yep, so I started networking and talked to enough people, and they had me perform. I even hopped on a cypher, too. So, and then after that, I would say the open mic was my second time performing.
Oh, shit. Get the fuck out of here, bro.
Yeah, this is my first few times, really.
Hell no.
Trying to perform and get
so,
it right.
Shout out to the brother that y'all don't see, but are you manager? Are you the manager? Like, what are you, security?
So, driver? Shout out my photographer / videographer /
I need one of you,
one
nigga.
One of the best people on my team right now. This is Prezi Lenz.
Okay, for sure, for sure. Yeah, tap in. You want to say something on camera right quick? Come on, nigga, come up here right quick. Got the people. Oh, shit. Don't worry about it. They didn't see it. They didn't see it. All right, there you go. Oh, they did see it. Hold on. We're going to let the people stop clapping right quick. And go ahead and talk to the mic, brother. Let them know who you is, man.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm Prezi Lenz. I'm a videographer. I'm a photographer. I shoot videos, so I'm the one that's behind the lens. She brings the talent. I just say action, and we make magic. We got videos on YouTube. We got more videos coming. 2024, get ready. Pay taking over.
If they wanted to hire you for booking, where can they find you at?
They can find me at Official Prezi Lenz. All right, that's official underscore Prezi, P-R-E-Z-Z-I, underscore Lens, L-E-N-S. And I'm on Instagram.
All right, for sure. There you have it. Appreciate you, brother. This nigga wiping his head. That shit hurting us. You gonna feel it in the car. That shit gonna swell up and all this shit.
Died to dry back.
Hey, so. Hey, so look, you, damn, so you new.
I'm new.
For real? So is this your first podcast?
It's my first podcast.
Is that right? Well, shit, I'm honored to have you on this motherfucker.
I'm honored
no,
to
but
be
I see your talent. You know what I'm saying? Like, I be seeing talent. Like, I really have an eye for talent. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you fucked me up saying that I was, like, your second time being on stage. You felt comfortable. You know what I'm saying? You felt comfortable, and you did your fucking shit. For real.
I appreciate that.
You got a song over? I want to hear it. Can you rap with it? I know Lil Big Cuz don't like that shit, but you ain't got no instrumental with you right now, do you? Ooh, you better pay attention, you old ass rappers. Nigga, she got an instrumental, nigga. She like, what it do? Cause Lil Big Cuz don't like you rapping over your shit. That's why I asked you, did you have an instrumental? And she going to find one. Ooh, she learning early. Fuck around, you need a manager? I'll manage you.
Do I need a manager?
Yeah, do you need a manager?
To be completely honest, no. You know, I don't need a manager just yet.
Right.
I ain't
gonna
lie, I've been doing everything by myself. That's like, so
good.
I got a team.
Keep
like,
doing
I have,
that shit.
I've been networking, so I have, you know, my photographer, my videographer, my engineers, my producers, you know.
As far as your fam, do they fuck with you? Do they fuck with the music?
Yeah, my man. They fuck with the music
they
hard.
They slapping your
they
shit in the wrist?
They fuck with it hard every time. My cousin pulled up one day because I posted a snippet, right? Uh-huh. I posted a snippet on my Instagram, and I guess my mom and my cousin was right around the car. They had to pick me up from the hair shop, and I was done doing hair. My mom would get out the car. She said, please send her this song. She been playing this snippet from the house all the way here. This same 15 seconds. One night. She's like, I can't keep hearing it.
Did you sing that? Did you sing that last week?
Yep.
You sang One Night. You got that on instrumental?
That I don't have an instrumental, but I sent that to him. Y'all could play that, but I'm finding my beat right now.
All right, boom. Oh, it's exclusive right here. Y'all in for a treat. I'm telling you. When you hear it spin, you'll be like, okay.
I'm about to just pull a quick one.
All right, boom. Even if you can't, you can rap over your shit. Everybody else doing it. But I just like how you was like, you was ready for the, she was ready for the cause. Like, let me find something right quick, nigga. Yeah. Instrumental. We'll have to put you, I'm going to have to get you on a show. I'm going to have to throw a show down, blood, so I can have her open up and shit and rock that bitch. We need an all-female show. Maybe I'll do an all-female show for the holidays. Man, come on. This is the fourth quarter. Hey, if anybody want to tap in right now, man, you can call us at 510-563-7819. Oh, you don't got it for him?
No, I'm about to send it to him. I just had to make sure this was it.
Okay. You got a backup.
Oh, you got a backup?
I'm loving this shit. Hey, can we go to a quick commercial break or can we play one? No, yeah. I want to hear all our shit, though. Can we go to a quick commercial break? All right, we're going to go to a quick commercial break, and then we'll be right back, man. We got something in store for y'all. For Peso, she in the building. We plugging her tonight.
Welcome to Sweetland, where the flavors of Jamaica come alive. Our talented chefs blend authentic Jamaican ingredients with a touch of love and passion. From tender oxtail stew to flavorful coconut shrimp to our snapper fish,
yeah,
we serve up the best of Jamaican cuisine. Whether you're looking for a taste of Jamaica or an unforgettable dining experience, Sweet Fingers is the place to be. Feel the rhythm, taste the spice, and immerse yourself in the vibrant Jamaican nightlife at our restaurant, where every night becomes a celebration of island flavors and unforgettable experiences. Come and experience the soulful flavors of Jamaica today. Nobody does it like Sweet Fingers, baby.
One, two, three.
Check. We back. Yo. We back. We official like a referee whistle.
It's the PA.
Shout out to Sweet Fingers too, man. They on a seminary in Foothill, man. Go get some jerk chicken and oxtails and all the shit.
Who got jerk chicken and oxtails over there?
Sweet Fingers.
Sweet Fingers.
It's on Seminary. They moved. They on Seminary in Foothill. No, that was just a commercial, though. I'm looking forward to this shit. Can you just come off the head? Are you a freestyle rapper?
I can be.
You can be?
Right now, I can say I'm doing stuff such as when I be in the car walking around, I'm rapping about like a hat or maybe this table with my phone so I can get there. I could do it. Like, and it's crazy because you know how, like, I don't know, I'll sit there and hear a beat and be in my head or I'll say something so tight by myself.
Right.
And flow and be cool and probably won't remember the 8 bars I just said.
Right.
But it's about just getting comfortable with the crowd. I just got comfortable in the performance. So
yeah, how did you feel on that night, on Monday?
I felt cool.
Because that was a cool little crowd.
That was great. I can say open mic Mondays and Wednesdays is like a great environment for a new artist. It's comfortable. You know, they got everything you need.
Right, everything.
So everything you need, it's a one-stop shop.
A one-stop
shop. Everybody there is very supportive. There's nobody like, you know, you ain't going to get booed. Nobody going to throw a tomato at you.
Right.
Anybody going to laugh at you.
See, I think the thing about these new artists that since I've been in the game, that I've noticed is that, you know, everybody try to get internet famous instead of going to the gyms. I call the artist retreat, that's like a gym. That's where you go and work out your shit. We used to do that as comedians back in the day. Used to be hella open mics. We used to hit the open mics. But nowadays, these niggas is lazy. They think that they gonna blow up because they got a couple views, a couple thousand or maybe a million views on social media. But nigga, isn't people coming to the actual show? Do you have actual supporters coming out to see you? That shit don't mean nothing if you ain't getting paid, if you ain't eating off that shit. And a lot of these new artists are in that's their mentality. They thinking that it's just gonna come to them. Like, nigga gonna give you something. Nah, you gotta get out here and grind for that shit. You gotta hit every open mic you can think of. You can, and if you know about a nigga throwing a show, man, can I get down right quick and keep your shit on you? You know what I'm saying? Like you doing. Like you on your shit right now.
One thing I'm gonna say is those people are not real.
Right. Oh yeah, that too. These niggas be buying likes and all that old weird ass shit. Why the fuck? Like, who are you trying to impress? That's sad for you to have to buy your likes, but like, god damn,
you know,
but really?
That, like, it don't matter how many views you have. Like, people right. could know you. You could be famous on the internet, but I'm all about being in person. You have to see me outside. I really do this. Like, I'm here. I'm a person. I really, you gonna see me working. It ain't gonna be no, she just popped up and was famous out of nowhere. No, I seen her passing out cards and CDs at the gas station.
She been here before, bud. She sound like a nigga from years ago. We ready? Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, you gonna see me. You're gonna know I'm a person. I feel like, so it's just not real. Yeah, you can have a million followers, but how many people gonna buy the product you actually selling instead of just reposting it? It don't work like that.
Where mom's at right now?
Mom's is at home.
Is she watching?
With Grams.
Hey, Grams, how you doing?
Hopefully she is.
Yeah,
if not,
she gonna watch it.
Sure.
Yeah. We gonna run that back. We gonna send that. You gonna have that in a minute.
I'm a mama look.
Right. So shout out to mom. Shout out to grandma. You know what I'm saying? I'm so proud. Y'all ladies have done a great job with this young lady. You know what I'm saying? She has her head on her shoulder. She could have been anywhere, but she here showing off her talent. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. Give it up, give it up, give it up.
No, judge me off my past. It's just my history. That shit will never last. I was just being me. I was, huh? And I'm just being me. Hey, huh? When you remember me, don't judge me off my past. It's just my history. That shit will never last. I was just being me, huh? Hey, and I'm just being me. Yeah, huh? And I never switch up. I might change my ways, just another level up. Can't get nowhere in the same place. You'll be stuck. I'm always want more, baby. This is not enough. Yeah, this is not enough, huh?
Hey,
that's cool.
Nigga, I had to tape that instead of go Facebook Live, cause I'm finna show people. I'm finna show people this young lady has not been rapping for a long time. And nigga, I asked her, did she have an instrumental? She said yeah, and did not rap over her shit. What the fuck, man? What the fuck? Let me sign you to TWO Records right now, man. If you don't want your producers all in the videos laughing and shit, go fuck with TWO.
Babe,
<Boy.
laughs>
On the B. And the B stands for Bay Life. Hey, no, for real, man. That man, come on, man. Come on, man. That's what's up. That you, man, I'm, man, look, I done had interviews in this motherfucker. And ask people. Some people don't even want to rap. They just want to hear their music play. I ask them. I give them the opportunity to do your thing like you did. I ain't had nobody come in here and had a shit instrumental and sit they speak their shit. You the first person out of hell of motherfucking artists that came up here. And I ain't dissing on none of my guests, but I'm just saying though, she's nigga 1 year doing this shit. Come on, man. One fucking year, her first fucking year, nigga. She's rapping acapella beat. Fuck is wrong with y'all, man? Y'all better step y'all motherfucking game up for now on.
You
know what?
Ask my uncle himself. I'm quick to pull up to the open mic like,
shout out to Uncle, man.
I just sent you something I made last night.
Keep pushing that inner, man. Keep pushing that inner. Oh, nigga, I'm finished. Your video, you're finna go viral. I mean, this shit go viral, nigga. That is not.
What I can say too is like, what pushed me even more to do it was one night we did the open mic and it was the competition, and I had went first. They was asking what you gonna do. I'm like, let me go. I'm like, let me go. Cool. And I did my thing, and then after like, Unc pulled me to the side. I was like, yo, because I wasn't really tripping. I was just like, okay, that's
we're
cool.
Unc at.
Like, I'm over here critiquing myself.
We're
I'm
Unc
like,
at.
You know, after this, I said, I'm like,
where Unc at? Where Unc at?
What Unc?
Oh, you talking about you?
Yes! Unc Igor. You feel me? He DJ.
Okay. 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 Yeah. I'm like, damn, you saying so much about Unc. Where that nigga at? This nigga right here.
Yeah, he, I'm
hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, nigga. Yeah, yeah. Talk your shit, little cuss.
Yeah, you know, I'm critiquing myself a little bit and stuff.
He teaching them early what not to do and what to do, man. Shout out to Lil Big Cuz, Igor B's Bay Life, man. Man, that goddamn, but yeah. Yeah, Lil Cuz. You got one.
Yeah, long story short, I was over there critiquing myself, and then, you feel me, he pulled me to the side like, yo. You don't even know. Like,
you
just
don't.
First, like, you just.
This nigga didn't tell me to say this.
You just set the bar. Like, why you okay? Yeah. I'm like, I did.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do it again.
Right. Nigga wanna go first every time. Let me go. Fuck it, I'll go. We got another one, Black? We ain't got another one? All right, well, fuck it. Can she rap over some shit?
No, this- I emailed you that one night. One night should be in the email. I emailed that one before I sent the beat.
I need a two-piece before we get up out of here. I know we got, yeah, man.
You got it? Yeah. This everybody's favorite.
Oh, this everybody's favorite?
It's everybody's favorite.
All right,
my
shit.
My mama favorite for sure.
Okay. Who make the beats? Who make the beats?
I have a few producers, so.
Okay,
we'll
get to them later.
Yeah, I got a couple of them.
Bait line, bait line, bait line, bait line, bait line.
Jay cook this one.
I really need us one night with you and me, baby. What you think? We better.
just one night with you and me, baby. What you think? We'll be right around to the sunlight. I like what I see, baby. Chill with me. When I'm with you, it just feels right. You all I need besides money in my week. When you hold me, baby, just squeeze tight. Just squeeze tight. I like the way that you make me feel.
Make me feel.
You make it seem so real. I'm digging your swag and your sex appeal. Only if looks can kill. On a D-Lo, baby, my lips see you. And trust me, I'll never squeal. There is no reason for me to reveal. Now, do we have a deal? You scratch my back and I scratch yours. Did you listen to the chorus? Tryna get to know you, tryna be a connoisseur. And we both entrepreneurs. Take a walk with me and let's open these doors. I know we've been at war. We stay back and forth, not the boat, but the oar. Just squeeze tight.
Yo, mama, gotta dance for that song. That's what you be doing. That's what's up.
I just actually dropped that song.
Yeah.
Well, I just put it on DistroKid last night, y'all. It's probably on Spotify right now. It might be on iTunes by like tonight, tomorrow morning.
Okay.
And then all platforms.
And all platforms.
You got to process.
Yeah, yeah. It's a process, but as long as you're taking it, that's what's up, man. You got any videos for your shit yet?
Mm-hmm.
You do? You got one for that?
Not yet. I have two videos, one from my song, The Rain. That was my first single, shot by him, Prezzy Lens, and then my second one, Something New, which I will be dropping this week.
Okay. Damn. Coming out, niggas. She's coming out with, right? I love it. I love it. And you independent.
Yes.
Man, don't that shit feel good, though?
Independent. It feels great.
And you ain't even seen it yet.
Nope.
You just playing the seeds, though.
I got 13 cents.
But you smelling playing the seeds.
I got 13 cents on DistroKid.
How many songs you got wrote?
I write all of my songs.
No, I'm saying, though, like how many songs you think you probably got?
What I have? I want to at least count, like, 15.
15? That's it?
At least what I got recorded.
That's 15. No, I'm just talking about songs. You know how niggas just write hella songs.
Maybe
shit?
I would say, I'll give you 25 maybe.
That's good.
I'll give you about 25 maybe.
Nigga, that's a double CD. For real, damn, but that's big. That's big, and that's just the beginning. And you write all your shit?
Everything.
Yeah.
Everything is written by me.
And then you say you do hair.
Yes, I do.
Where you do hair at?
I do hair on West Grand at the Barber Lounge, 943 West Grand Ave.
What kind of hair you do? You do the long shit. You
braids,
cut hair? You
weaves, cut hair? Weaves, not yet.
Not yet?
I'm working on it.
For real?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Fuck
I'm,
it.
I already went to cosmetology school. I take my state board in December. So once I get that license, I might go back and do my 200 hours so I can get my barber license too.
Go for it. Fuck yeah.
Cutting hair.
You're a one-stop shop.
Yes. For real.
For real. You said on West Green?
Yep, on West Green.
So if they come in, they gotta have an appointment.
Yes, most of the time, not even most of the time, you will need an appointment. It's very rare that there will be a day that I'm not doing anything. And you call me and you can have an appointment, but it's not always guaranteed. I would have to have a cancellation or, like I said, have a dry day.
Yeah. So
definitely want an appointment.
Which one you like better?
Appointment.
No, I'm saying which one you like better, hair or rapping?
Ooh. What I will say is that
this is an honest answer to him.
What
like, ooh.
I will say is that hair is what is my main resource of money right now. So that, of course, takes more of my time, and it's something that I will do more often than music. If music was to possibly outweigh hair, then it'd be different.
Yeah.
But
I'm going to ask you that question in a year from now.
But I do enjoy doing hair. Like, I do enjoy it. That's something I love to do. But like I said, so far as long term or, you know, shit take time.
Hell yeah. And I'm telling you, you a youngster, so by the time you get like 40, your motherfucking hands gonna be crippling up and shit.
Yeah,
carpal tunnel and all
kind of
shit, arthritis. Like, oh, hell no.
To answer your question of what I like to do more is music. But, you know, so far as what's making me more money is hair, so.
Okay.
Gotta establish that.
That definitely makes sense. So, yeah, the music is gonna come. Because you out here doing shit different. Like you doing things that a lot of people that have been rapping at least 5 years is not doing. And you coming out the dough.
Swinging.
Right.
Head first.
For real, you independent. Somebody gonna snatch you up. I'm telling you, somebody gonna tell you, be like, hey, little mama, look at this contract. Lil Cuz leg went like, Lil Cuz, read this.
It's coming. Well,
some nigga with some change gonna be like, man, I'll see you some dinner. We gonna have to talk off the live though, cause for real. But I see your future. I see a beautiful future. I see a bright future. For real. I seen that night. And then to know that you only been doing this shit. That was your second, third show. It's like, damn.
Yep.
And I think that night, if I want to say that you did that night. You didn't rap over your what's name. And I think that's what caught my ear.
Yeah, that night I rapped over my voice.
You did?
I did. For the past few nights, I've been rapping over my voice just because I've been waiting to put me together and mix or get all my instruments together. I just haven't taken the time to do so, but no more lip syncing. No more lip syncing. It's over. I gotta know my raps.
You should come out
and
with
not
a
even
t-shirt
that,
to say that.
It's just like cardio.
You should come out with a t-shirt to say that.
No more raps?
No more lip syncing.
No more lip syncing?
You might start a trend with that one. You might start a trend with that one.
We're not gonna talk about it no more.
Especially if you pull up on the shows and really not lip syncing. Oh shit!
They know too much already.
No, for real,
we
fuck that. Hey, be on the lookout. We got one, B. Okay, so you how did you come up with your name?
Peso.
Yes.
That's been my name since like high school. It started off as my Instagram. It was freshman year. Freshman year, everybody's putting their Instagram names together. I seen some people call me Mo. Mo, Peso. Just switch up the letters a little bit. I was just matching it with my name. Then somebody, you know, brought to my attention like, no, Mo Pesos. That's Mo Money. Okay. I like that. I just took it and ran with it. Peso.
So now you Big Peso.
Big Peso.
Nigga. That was where I was going to. I'm like, nigga, because her name is Peso, but she Big Peso now.
Big Peso. All capitals.
Tuck your shit. All capitals. Hey, and it is, though. All capitals. Oh shit. So what you got coming up next?
Next up, what do I got? Well, of course, these next couple Mondays and Wednesdays, I will be on 39th at the Open Mic Artist Retreat, performing my, you know, few songs. Towards the end of this month, I can't exactly remember the date. I believe in maybe the 29th, I have a performance at Zanzia.
Okay.
That's
a nice spot. They sound is real good.
Yep. 29th, I have a performance up there, and then I also will be over there this Friday. I should be up there this Friday.
Yeah. So you out here?
Yes.
Doing your thing and shit for real. If you get some flyers of some upcoming events, tap in. You know what I'm saying? We'll post that on the commercial breaks and shit like that though. But I'm really proud of you and shit. I see something different. You know what I'm saying? I see something different. And I, no shade to no female artist that's rapping out here prior to you that I know, but I see something different. You know what I'm saying? And it's a good look. You know what I'm saying? It needed to be seen. And I'm here for it. And that's why you on here representing your shit.
If they want to follow you, where can they follow you at?
At Mo Peso, that is at MOEPAYSO. That is my artist page. And so far as hair, that is Peso the brand. So PAYSO the brand. And then what I can say too is about the being different, like 2023, this year especially, I've really been working on myself. Just spending a lot of time by myself, noticing stuff I liked, stuff I didn't like, stuff that I wanted to change, stuff I didn't want to change. So it just pushed me to really be myself, and that really helps with the music, because now it's really like, when I first started doing music, I almost had like a little breakdown. It was a lot, because I take stuff serious. Like, right. I when I do something, I go all in. I don't play no games. So when I first started music, I had like a battle with myself, because it was like, you can tell me my music good, you can tell me you don't like my music, it don't matter. I gotta like my music first. It don't matter how many people tell me they like my music.
Right.
That don't matter if I don't like my own music. I have to believe in myself and be comfortable with myself in order to really, you know, be authentic and strive. That's the only way it's gonna be right.
Yeah.
You can tell the difference.
Yeah.
It's easy to get, you know, soaked up in the wrong things when you don't know yourself.
Exactly. That's real talk. And this is coming from a young lady, 21, from Richmond, California.
Yeah.
Doing her thing, man, for real. You want to give a shout-out to anybody?
Like I said, shout-out to Prezi Lens. Shout-out to L, that's one of my producers. Noah, I think his Instagram is Max. I know that's a photographer, produced by Sue. That's another producer. He produced my beats as well. Produced by Mitchell. He got the studio. Unc Igor, Shop Studios. My partner Noah. And, I think that's about it. If I forgot anybody, don't text me. Don't call me. Y'all know I love y'all. I just, you know.
Straight up. My bad, nigga.
My bad.
Catch you
on
the next one.
It's all love. I got you. Don't be yelling at me after this. It's no hard feelings.
real talk. Well, yeah, man, I want to say thank you for blessing my podcast today with your talent. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
I said, I seen it last week and was like, man, yeah, she raw. And then to come in here and, you know, the question of you not rapping over your music, I mean, over your lyrics, that was just some random shit because I didn't have nothing planned. I just was talking. And you was prepared. So that fucked me up. Like, oh, shit. And then did it. Oh, yeah.
Don't tell me nothing. I don't play.
Yeah, yeah. That was,
I'm one of them people. Don't tell me nothing if you don't want me to do it now.
That was real. That was grande. That people were watching this right now like, yep, she did just do it. She did do what he said. She did that. Yeah, she did, nigga, for real. Watch this shit again. But, yeah, thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for blessing this podcast and being a part of Mad Mondays. Keep doing your thing. I'm going to keep supporting you. Anytime you want to pop up and whatever, co-host, have
you,
a video.
I'm involved.
Give me a video. I'll play the shit on my shit. Whatever it is. You know what I'm saying? It's all love from me to you. So I just want to say thank you. Keep doing your thing. God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Richmond, nigga. For real. Respect the rich tonight, nigga. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for Big Peso.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
Real
tough. And we'll be back after these messages. This is Mad Mondays, man.
Swollen Air Productions. Still loud when I
cup of cognac, tap a man deal in the deck. It's all about the profit. Catch me in that Buick Bobby, jamming, smoking on them flowers. Contemplating on my next move, calculated steps. Need precision like an army. March, nigga, step.
Keep your tie tight, nigga. Watch where you step.
Watch it. 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 Watch it.
You better watch your step. You better watch your step. You better watch your step. Watch it. You better watch your step.
Jamming, risky it all, pouring deuce like it's Kool-Aid. Toting on the mural, blowing smoke just like a choo train. Back in 05, it was swooshes and them choo things. I would transform on them red and blue things. But I didn't hoop bang, then why my shoe man? These bitches on my feet clean, kick like Luke Kane. I'm the troop man, all pressure, no brakes, all gas. If you playing, I catch you. That's your ass, I step you. Yeah, nigga, back in it, been like nothing happened. Where I been? Well, let me tell you, on the grind hard, trying to make the shit happen.
Watch it, watch it, ay, 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 watch it, watch it, ay. You better watch your step. You better watch your step. You better watch your step. You better watch your step.
Said all that on live. Hey, it's your boy Wild Out, aka Two Man. That was a nigga. That was an interview right there. It's like, I don't know. And I always say this. I'm like, every interview is good, but every show is good. Every show I've had has always been a great show. But it seemed like that next one, every one that happens after that be some other shit. This one right here was it, though, for real. You taught a lot of gems. You might have hurt some feelings with this one. For real. You might have hurt some feelings with this one. This was major, nigga. For real. This was, I can't wait to show the video. Man, for real. She came in here and did her motherfucking thing. Shout out to her. Yeah, she's big, boy. It ain't little no more. It's not a game. It's not a game. She's big now. This was a great show, a little bit cuss. Shit. Yeah, nigga, I'm high. yeah, it's going down. Thank y'all for tuning in, because we finna wrap this motherfucker up. What you got going on this week, little bit cuss?
Oh, man. Artist Retreat. DM me.
It's going down. Yeah, tap
hit
in.
Hit me twice and hit white out. Get an invite.
Tap in.
I give it to you, but you got to be invited. This is exclusive, invite
yeah,
only.
Some of these niggas didn't get it. She right. said it. I was like, oh, no, you
yeah. Right, right. Yeah, see, yeah,
but she said say, it. She, yeah, you, they didn't hear that.
Yeah. You had to rewind.
Hey, I was like on Martin when that nigga Dave Chappelle got the gun. No, don't just hand it to me. I got to take it from you.
But we there Mondays and Wednesdays. You know, Friday, I'm back at the longest bar in Oakland, the Aloha Bar.
Miss P said, good show. Thank you, baby. Appreciate
you feel
it.
Me? Oh, and then check this out. This Sunday, I'm at the Lucky 777 on Fruitvale. You know what I'm saying? And y'all come through and support. We'll be out there with some Raider football. No, it'll just be football. It'll be football all day. I just had to slide that in because we won this week, y'all. We finally won. We
you can
finally
talk
won.
That shit this week.
You feel me? We finally won,
we
y'all.
We're going to see if that same energy is here next Monday.
They lose, I'm being quiet.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I don't know. I be in the streets and fucking with people and networking and trying to make some shit happen. So I've been on Free My Head since the reunion.
Right.
So once again, man, shout out to everybody at Castlemont. I appreciate y'all for letting the nigga from Free My High fuck with y'all. Y'all gave me hospitality. It was all love. What else is going on? I don't know. The boat cruise this Thursday. It's a couple open mics, I think, this week. But yeah, if you follow me on Facebook, you can see, you know what I'm saying, I'm going to post whatever's going on this week. Shout out to Cal Pep and Level Up. That's what I do for the people that's really out here trying to really help people. If you need a job, tap in with me. If you need resources, the housing, tap in with me. If you need shit, anything right now, just tap in with me. I probably got a hookup on something. And that's what it is. We networking. It's all about the network, people. And we appreciate y'all for tuning in every Monday for what, the 12th or the 4th season? Thank y'all, each one of y'all. Y'all be safe out here. God bless y'all. We'll see y'all next Monday. Two out.
Yeah, I'm with the funnies, yep. Laughing out loud, man, that's how I get this money, boy, boy style. Man, you know how I'm moving, man, you see what I'm doing, all the paper I'm pursuing, boy style. Yeah, I'm with the funnies, yep. Laughing out loud, man, that's how I get this money, boy style.